Hello everyone. Today we'll be learning a topic in discrete mathematical structures. Subject code is 18CS36. In module 2, that is fundamental principles of counting, we'll be learning about rules of sum and product. Myself, Dr. Madhura, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mathematics, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Yelahanka, Bengaluru. Let us first see the definition for the sum rule. Suppose there are two tasks, T1 and T2, such that T1 can be performed in m different ways, T2 can be performed in n different ways, and if these two tasks cannot be performed simultaneously, means we do not take up these two tasks together, then one of the tasks T1 or T2 can be performed in m plus n ways. Say for example, suppose a library has 12 books on mathematics, 10 books on physics, 16 books on computers. And suppose a student wishes to choose one of these books to study, then the number of ways he can choose the book is 12 plus 10 plus 16, which is 38 ways. So student, when he wishes to study, he cannot simultaneously study the maths book, physics book, and the computer book. So he'll be choosing, or he'll be wishing, one of the book to be chosen. So once he want to choose one of the book, it can be done in 12 plus 10 plus 16, which is 38 ways. Now the next definition is on product rule. If T1 and T2 are two tasks, such that T1 can be performed in m different ways, and for each of these ways, T2 can be performed in n different ways, then both the tasks can be performed in m into n different ways. So as before, we have two tasks here, T1 and T2. So for each of the T1 tasks, T2 can be performed in n different ways. So both simultaneously can be performed in m into n different ways. That's the product rule definition. Say for example, suppose a person has 8 shirts and 5 ties. Then the number of ways of choosing a shirt and a tie is 8 into 5, which is equal to 40 ways. So that's about the definition. Let's see problems part in sum and product rule. First question. Cars of a particular company come in 4 models, 12 colors, 3 engine sizes, and 2 transmission types. How many distinct cars of this company can be manufactured? Another subpart of the question is, of these, how many have the same color? So, cars of a particular company they occur in 4 models. There are 4 different models, and there are totally 12 colors and 3 engine sizes, and they are of 2 transmission types. So we are asked to find out how many distinct cars of this company can be manufactured. So for each of those 4 models, we'll be choosing 12 colors, and we'll be choosing 3 engine types and 2 transmission types. So it's an application of product rule for the first sub question, right? So solution says that the number of distinct cars that can be manufactured is 4 into 12 into 3 into 2. That is 4 models. For each of those models, we'll be choosing 12 colors, For each of those four models and 12 colors, simultaneously we'll be choosing three engine size and two transmission types. So 4 into 12 into 3 into 2, which leads to 288. The second part of the question is, of these manufactured types, how many have the same color? It is given that the cars has 12 different colors. So for each of those 12 colors, we'll have to choose the models, engine sizes, and the two transmission types. So for any particular chosen color, number of distinct cars that can be manufactured is 4 into 3 into 2. 4 because there are 4 models. And for each of those color, we'll be choosing 3 engine types. So it is 3. And there are 2 transmission types, so into 2. So 4 into 3 into 2, which is 24. So this problem was simple and understandable, I believe. It was based on purely the product rule. Let's see the next question. Determine the number of 6-digit integers, no leading zeros. So when we say it should be a 6-digit integer, the leading entry cannot be 0, right? Or else it becomes a 5-digit integer. So no leading zeros is obvious, in which particular cases are no digit is repeated, no digit is repeated and it is even, no digit is repeated and is divisible by 5. So these are the sub cases that we have to check with. Let's see the solution. So very first case says that we need to find out the number of 6-digit integers without leading zeros, in which no digit is repeated. So none of the digits are repeated. So to form a 6-digit number with no leading zeros and without repetition, the first place can be filled in 9 ways. The very leading entry can have 9 different possibilities. That's because when I say the word digits, digits are from 0 to 9. So 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 9. So there are totally 10 in number. So there are 10 digits in general. So very first place cannot have 0. So that's why it can occupy the remaining digits. The remaining digits are 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 9. So which can be chosen in 9 different ways. Right? We are not choosing 0 in the very beginning place, very leading entry position place. Then the second place can be filled in 9 ways. How is the second place can be filled in 9 ways? 0 is allowed here. We should not have the digits repeated. So it is without repetition case. So since the digits should not be repeated, the second place can occupy 0, but it should not occupy the place which was already there in the first position. It can have 0 and all other digits. Together it counts to 9. So second place can be chosen in 9 ways. Third can be chosen in 8 ways. First position and second position places are left. So remaining is 8 digits. That's why 8 ways. Fourth place in 7 ways. Fifth place in 6 ways, and the last units place in 5 ways. So this can be done in 9 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5, which leads to 1,36,080. Right? So we had 6 digit numbers. The very leading entry cannot take 0, so it can be filled in 9 different ways. Except 0, it can occupy all other digits, so 9 different ways. The second place can be chosen in again 9 different ways because 0 is allowed here. but it should not occupy the previous digit which was already taken care of. So this can also be chosen in 9 different ways. Third position can be filled in 8 ways because we have to leave the first position entry and the second position digit. We are not supposed to repeat any of the digits. So that's why it can be done in 8 different ways. Fourth position in 7 ways. It's because we are leaving first, second and the third place digits. So it can be chosen in 7 ways. Similarly, fifth and the sixth position can be chosen in 6 and the 5 ways. So product of all these gives us the required answer for first subdivision. Product, because simultaneously we are trying to take care of these things being happening. All the 6 positions has to be filled simultaneously. So that was our first case. Now the second case is no digit is repeated and it is even. So again, none of the digits should be repeated from 0 to 9. And also the number, the 6 digit number, has to be an even number. So since it has to be an even number, the last digit or the digits in the units place can take 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. The units place can occupy only the even numbers. Of course, here I have to include 0 also because it is also one of the digit in the units place which leads to an even number. So units place has to be 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. Now here occurs 2 possible cases that can arise. Firstly, the units place can be 0 only, or the units place can be 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. So let's see those cases. If the units place is 0, that is, we are talking about only one particular choice to the units place, then the number of ways of doing this is 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 1. Let me explain how it is. So very firstly, the units place has to be 0 itself. So I am talking about one particular choice only. So units place has only one choice. Now coming on to the very first place, it can never take a 0. So we have 9 more possibilities to happen. So 9 choices, this can be chosen in 9 ways. Then the second position can be occupied in 8 ways because it cannot take the first place digit. Whatever the first place digit was there, it cannot occupy that value. And it cannot also occupy 0, which is already fixed to the units place. So this can also take only 8 positions. Third position can take 7 ways, because it has to exclude the first 2 positions as well as the last place which is fixed for units, that is 0. Similarly, fourth and the fifth places can be chosen in 6 and the 5 ways. So this product leads us to 15,120. Say this is equal to S1. Some notation I've used here. This will be again useful for us, this value. That is the reason I have denoted it by S1. Now, if the units place is filled by 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, right? Since the number or the integer has to be an even integer, it can occupy 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. We have already seen that. First, we spoke about a particular value 0 only. Now it can occupy 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 together, excluding 0 we are talking. So we are talking about 4 choices. Then the number of ways of doing this is 8 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4. So let me tell you how is this. The units place has to be filled in 4 ways, 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. So that's the reason units place is occupying 4 here. Then coming on to the first place, it is excluding 0. The very first place can never occupy a 0 value, or else it becomes a 5 digit number. Here I have to obtain a 6 digit integer. So that's the reason this can never take 0. So excluding 0. and excluding that even digit which is occupied in the unit's place. So one of them, 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, will be occupied in the unit's place, right? So excluding one of them. Okay, so it occupies in 8 different ways. Into 8 again, second position is occupied again by 8 places. Why again 8? It cannot occupy the first position value and it cannot occupy that digit which is already fixed to the unit's place. But it can have a 0. It can occupy a value that is 0. So that is why we have 0 and the remaining digits which counts to 8. Similarly, the next third position can be filled in 7 different ways. We have to leave the even digit here, 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. And we have to leave the first two positions, which is already occupied. Remember that the digits should not be repeated. So this can be done in 7 different ways. Similarly, fourth and the fifth position are chosen. So this product leads to 53,760. Say this is equal to S2. Therefore, total number of ways of doing this is. Now just understand the situation. Since the last digit or the digit in unit's place has to occupy 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 to be even, either this first case occupying 0 can happen, or the second case that is occupying 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 can happen. Both simultaneously cannot happen. So it's an application of sum rule. So total number of ways of doing this is S1 plus S2. Either this first case can happen or the second case can happen. So that is why we have to apply the sum rule here. So which is S1 plus S2, which leads to 68,880. Hope you have followed this case. Now coming on to the third case, third subdivision. That is, the number has to be divisible by 5. If the number has to be divisible by 5, the last digit or the digit in unit's place has to occupy 0 or 5. Recalling the tables of 5, right? The unit's place can be either 0 or 5 only. It cannot occupy any other digits in the unit's place. So we have two different cases to deal with. Again, if the unit's place occupies 0, what happens? If the unit's place occupies 5, what happens? So those two cases we'll be discussing now. If the unit's place is 0, that is one particular choice I'm talking about, the number of ways of doing this is 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 1. As discussed in the previous subdivision, we are already familiar with this. Unit's place is occupying only one choice, fix it to 0. So that's why 1 here. Excluding that 0, all other digits can take the first position. So that's why 9 digits, 1 to 9, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 9. So 9 digits, that's why 9 ways in the first position. Excluding the first position value and 0, remaining digits can occupy here. So that's why 8. Excluding the first position, second position and the 0 which is occupied in the unit's place, remaining digits can take to the third position. So that's why 7 ways. Similarly, 6 and 5. Again, this product is 15,120. Say this is equal to S3. Now another case, the unit's place can occupy 5. So if the unit's place occupies 5, which I'm talking about only one particular choice, then the number of ways of doing this is 8 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 1. So how is this product? Let me explain. Unit's place is occupying 5. So last position, that is one choice, whatever we have written here. The unit's place is occupying only 5. Correct? Now coming back to the first position. First position can be filled in 8 different ways because it cannot have a leading zero. It cannot occupy 5 because it is already fixed to the unit's place. No digits should be repeated. So do remember that. So this can be occupied in 8 different ways, excluding 0 and 5. That's why 8 different positions. Into 8 again because this place can take 0. But we have to exclude 5, which is already fixed to the unit's place. And we also have to exclude that digit which is occupying the first position. So excluding the first position digit and 5, which is occupied in the unit's digit, this can be done in 8 different ways. Second place can be filled in 8 different ways. Similarly, third place can be filled in 7 different ways. That is excluding first 2 positions and the last digit, which is already fixed to 5. Similarly, fourth and the fifth positions gets lesser with one number. And we have 6 into 5. This product leads to 13,440. Say this is equal to S4. Therefore, total number of ways is equal to, for this case, that is, the digit has to be, the integer has to be divisible by 5. So total number of ways of doing this is S3 plus S4, which leads to 28,560. Why are we applying the sum rule here again? It's because either the unit's place can occupy 0 or it can occupy 5. Both simultaneously cannot happen. Either the first case can happen or the second case can happen. That's the reason, sum rule. So whenever the word or is dealt with, it always stands up to the sum rule. Whenever simultaneous things are getting happened, then it's always the application of product rule. Let's see the next problem. A bit is either 0 or 1. And a byte is a sequence of 8 bits. So all the computer science students are most familiar with this. Question is to find the number of bytes. In the first case, we just have to find the number of bytes. Second case, the number of bytes that begin with 1, 1 and end with 1, 1. And the third case is the number of bytes that begin with 1, 1 and do not end with 1, 1. And lastly, the number of bytes that begin with 1, 1 or end with 1, 1. So let's see how to do this problem. Since each byte contains 8 bits and each bit is a 0 or 1, that is 2 choices, the number of bytes is 2 power 8. So suppose I have 8 bits. In one byte, there are 8 bits, no? And each of those bits can occupy the choices, that is 0 or 1. That is 2 choices it can take. So total number of bytes becomes 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 8 times. So when 2 is multiplied 8 times, it is same as writing 2 power 8, which leads to 256. So that's the total number of bytes. That is the first subdivision. Now coming on to the second subdivision. In a byte beginning and ending with 1, 1, so the first 2 bits should be filled with 1 and 1, and the last 2 also should be 1 and 1. So in the middle, how many empty positions are there? In a byte, there are 8 bits, no? So first 2 are occupied with 1, 1. Last 2 are occupied with 1, 1. So obviously in the middle, there are 4 empty positions. So these four empty positions can be filled in 2^4 ways. That is 16 ways. So how is it 2^4? Each of those four empty positions has two choices, either 0 or 1. Correct? So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 becomes 2^4, which is 16 ways. Now coming on to the third and the fourth subdivision, what I felt was explaining along with a Venn diagram would be easy rather than doing directly. So I'll be explaining third and the fourth subdivision with the help of a Venn diagram concept. Okay. So what is the third case? Number of bytes that begin with 1, 1 and do not end with 1, 1. Similarly, fourth case is number of bytes that begin with 1, 1 or end with 1, 1. So these two I felt easy making you to understand with the help of a Venn diagram. So let's solve the third and fourth concept using Venn diagram. So let us consider the set A and the set B. And we have these things to understand in our Venn diagram. So if this is set A and this is set E, right? Then A intersection B complement. So this entire part is nothing but the A intersection B complement. The intersection part usually is denoted by A intersection B. We are all familiar with it. And this particular part here in the right hand is A complement intersection B. Right? Let us now first assume that A stands for beginning with 1, 1. And let us assume the set B as end with 1, 1. Then what happens to A intersection B? A intersection B will be nothing but begin and end with 1, 1. And A union B stands for begin or end with 1, 1. So usually in the set theory, we understand that union stands for or and intersection stands for and. Right? We are all familiar with it. Now with this idea, let us try to analyze what we have to find out in the third case and what we need to find out in the fourth case. Third case is that number of bytes that begin with 1, 1 and do not end with 1, 1. So begin with 1, 1 means A and usually stands for intersection. So A intersection do not end with 1, 1. So do not end with 1, 1 means B complement. If B is ending with 1, 1, B complement will be do not end with 1, 1 concept. So for the third subdivision, we need to find out A intersection B complement. That is the value of this here in the Venn diagram. A intersection B complement we need to find out for the third subcase. Similarly, let's see what is to be found out in the fourth subcase. The number of bytes that begin with 1, 1 or end with 1, 1. Begin with 1, 1 stands for A. End with 1, 1 stands for B. Or in the middle says it is union. So we need to find out A union B for the fourth subcase. So let us perform that. Now to find, as mentioned, A intersection B complement. So from the figure, A intersection B complement is A minus of A intersection B. Right? You can observe that easily from the Venn diagram which was drawn to you. So A intersection B complement is obtained by A minus A intersection B. So A is nothing but beginning with 1, 1. So if the digits occupy 1, 1 in the first two positions, then the remaining six positions, six because a byte has 8 bits. So out of those 8 bits, first two positions are fixed as 1, 1. So remaining is only 6 positions. each one of those six positions can be filled by 0 or 1. So two choices. So that's the reason it is 2 power 6 here. 2 into 2 into 2 into how many times? 6 times, which leads to 2 power 6 minus 2 power 4. That is A intersection B value here is 2 power 4. So why is A intersection B 2 power 4? A intersection B stands for begin with 1, 1 and end with 1, 1. So first two positions are 1, 1. Last two positions are also 1, 1. Remaining is in the middle 4 empty positions. So those 4 empty positions in the middle can be filled in 2 power 4 ways. 2 power 4 because each of them can take 0 or 1. And this 4 positions empty. That's why 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 2 power 4. So this value leads to 64 minus 16, which is equal to 48 ways. So a number, a byte beginning with 1, 1, but do not end with 1, 1 is 48. Moving on to the fourth case, that is to find, as mentioned, it is to find A union B. That is beginning with 1, 1 or ending with 1, 1. So we are already familiar with the set theory concept that for any two finite sets A and B, A union B is always obtained by A plus B minus of A intersection B. That is cardinality of A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. So number of elements in A means beginning with 1, 1. Beginning with 1, 1 means only the first two positions are filled. Remaining six positions can be filled in 2 power 6 ways. Similarly, number of elements in B is 2 power 6 because B stands for ending with 1, 1. If the byte has to end with 1, 1, the first six positions can be filled in 2 power 6 ways. Minus A intersection B is 2 power 4, which we saw here in the previous case. So calculating this, the sum leads to 112. So this was a different variety of application of sum and product rule. Let's move on to the next one. Find the number of proper divisors of 441,000. So we need to find out the proper divisors of this number. So very firstly, let us understand what do we mean by proper divisors. Proper divisors are all those divisors of that particular number excluding 1 and itself. So if I am talking about 441,000, right, I have to check all other divisors of 441,000. And when I want to calculate the number of proper divisors, it is excluding 1 and that number itself. So first let us find out the total number of divisors of this number, that is 441,000. So this can be represented as 2 cube into 3 square into 5 cube into 7 square. So how all of a sudden I have written this is using our usual divisor concept. So I keep on dividing by 2 and then I find that it leads to 55,125. Later I will divide by 5s. Later 441 can be divisible by 3s. Then 49 can be divisible by 7. So like that we find out all the divisors. So just observe here 2 into 2 into 2. So that's why 2 cube. 5 into 5 into 5. So that's the reason 5 cube. 3 into 3. So 3 square. 7 into 7. And that's the reason 7 square. So all these are nothing but the factors for divisors for 441,000. So we observe that every divisor of n, which is equal to 4 lakh 41,000 must be of the form the divisor D, I have denoted by D, which is equal to 2 power P into 3 power Q into 5 power R into 7 power S. So we saw that it is divisible, the number 441,000 is divisible by 2, 3, 5 and 7. So the divisor must be of the form 2 power P say into 3 power Q into 5 power R into 7 power S say, where P takes the value from 0 to 3. We saw that it was 2 cube. So it takes a value from 0, 1, 2 and 3. And we also saw that it was into 3 square. So 3 square, so it can, Q can take the value from 0 to 2, 0, 1 or 2. Similarly, it was 5 cube. So R can take the value from 0 to 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. And S ranges from 0 to 2 because it was 7 square. So we observed or we understood that every divisor of this number 441,000 can be of the form 2 power P into 3 power Q into 5 power R into 7 power S, where P, Q, R, S ranges from respectively what has been mentioned, that is 0 to 3, 0 to 2, 0 to 3 and 0 to 2. Therefore, total number of divisors is equal to 4 into 3 into 4 into 3. So how is this number? Let me explain. Since P ranges from 0 to 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So I'm talking about four different choices. That's reason 4 here. Similarly, Q ranges from 0 to 2. So it can take 0 or 1 or 2. So I'm talking about three different choices. So that's the reason 3 here. And similarly, R ranges from 0 to 3. So 0, 1, 2, 3, four different choices. So again, 4. And lastly, S varies from 0 to 2. 0, 1, 2. Three different choices. So 3. So this is for total number of divisors. This product leads to 144. So total number of divisors is 144. So when I want to talk about total number of proper divisors, then it is excluding 1 and the number itself. So total number of proper divisors gives me excluding all those divisors, excluding 1 and itself. So leaving those 1 and the number 441,000 itself, I have to subtract 144 by 2. So 144 minus 2 leads to 142. The reason behind is we are excluding the number 1 and the number itself, that is 441,000. Hope these problems on sum and product rule were helpful to understand the concept. Thank you.